What does it mean for you to be part of this year's festival?
It's wonderful. It's really nice to be surrounded by fellow horror film fans. I'm a huge horror fan. To be here and just to see people that geek out as horror movies as much as I do is a lot of fun.
What do you think audiences and performers get from the horror genre that they don't from other types of cinema?
Well, they get to go and kind of relive their sick, dark, twisted fantasies that hopefully they will never recreate in real life. It's you can go into this dark cinema space and you can be scared or you can, you know, you can feel power through the antagonist, you know, killing people. It's a way to escape, really.
Talking about this film, for people who haven't seen it, can you give us a quick synopsis and tell us about where your leading man fits in?
He is, I mean, he's the hero. He's on a quest to try and save his girlfriend from the hands of this sick and twisted, demented projectionist. So he's pretty much, yeah, he's the hero. Well, yeah, we'll see.
I mean, you're working alongside Robert, an absolute icon of the horror genre. Were you nervous and excited the first time you met him as a horror fan? Obviously, Freddy Krueger himself.
Actually, I remember when I was really little. I was probably 8 years old, and I couldn't sleep. And I went downstairs, and I was like really tired. And I turned on the TV, and it was the first experience of seeing a kind of a horror movie character, and it was Freddy Krueger, and it scared me so much. And then, so that was my first imprint of having like a horror affect me. And then meeting Robert on set, he's the complete opposite. He's such a lovely, charming, generous, caring and thoughtful man. It was wonderful to work with him. He's a real pro, and it's wicked to work with such an icon as well.
Of course, I mean, the film set inside a cinema. Did that present any particular challenges? Can you talk about your experiences on set?
It was a lot of fun. It's actually a little bit weird being back in the Vue Cinema now, because every time I go into a Vue Cinema, I'm like, oh, you know, is there someone watching me? But it was really nice to work in a place which just feels so authentic. There was little to imagine because you were actually in the cinema after dark and there was no one else around. So it was very eerie at times. I remember I'd sometimes, you know, in between takes, I'd just wander around some of the quiet cinema screens. And it was eerie, man. Really, yeah, scary.
Do you think that your experiences working on Thrones have kind of desensitized you now to blood and violence and the dark side of life?
Yeah, I think it has. I think it has a little bit, you know. I'm a bit, oh, look, another dead corpse and whatever. Yeah, I think it has a little bit.
Have you got a message for fans about why they should be going out and running to see The Last Show?
Not showing. Well, there are several reasons. It's independent cinema, and it's really good independent British cinema. It's really cleverly made by our director and writer, Phil Hawkins. And it's intelligent. It's a psychological thriller which has a homage to a horror movie. So it's not clear cut down the line. It's intelligent. I think he's kind of saying the same things as I am. But yeah, just go see it. It's wicked. I'm in it. Come on.